I got a couple of ideas. You know, that's why I had started talking about those satellites and different things and traveling in a sphere where you couldn't feel motion or heat or anything was the only way you could get to Mars. I seen something like that when I was looking at the satellites. But I can tell now that the sun is closer to the Earth than it's ever been. And it's getting hotter than it's ever been. But a different type of heat. It's a lot of radiation type stuff going on now. And I noticed that about Arizona. We're right at the pinpoint of it. But my opinion, the sun has got closer to the Earth. It's going to be unusual weather from this point on. You know, record-breaking where it didn't snow before or melting polar caps. All from that space junk. All that space junk flying around gold and silver reflecting the sun's radiation and superheating a certain part of the Earth has already happened yet. Already have happened, and it feels like Arizona, because Arizona, I've spent some time in El Paso, and it's not the same type of heat, and it's definitely not the same era. I was there in 79 and 80 to 83, and it used to be hot and it used to be cold at night, but not like this. This is every year. If you noticed last Christmas and Christmas before then, how the weather's changed dramatically, and nobody's paying any attention because they got their mind off on something else. They don't. I wonder about the little things of life now, since I'm getting to the end of mine, and just the little stuff amazes me that you amass so much knowledge. And that's why I say you don't mass so much knowledge and die and you don't come back. You go to somewhere else, like those places y'all trying to visit. That might be your next place you visit. But shit, you gotta, only if you do right on this plane first. You know, I know that's a lot of faith and whatever, but how y'all live is you living every day the best you can live until you die. And then when you die, just because you don't see your parents anymore or something, a ghost or whatever, you figure they're dead is dead. So I'm gonna live like, you know, you living for no tomorrow. And you've always lived like that. You want as much time on earth, I don't care how rich you are, you will still die. I don't care how rich you are. Can't nobody save you from dying. And you start dying the first day you're born. And so you want to stay here now that you amassed all this knowledge, and things wasn't like in life that you thought it was, and you were more than people say you were. And when you find out all that, like I went from El Paso the same night, my brother got me hooked on cocaine for 30 years on and off, and it took 30 years to get back to a place that made sense, but it's the next state over. So I wanted to, I drove my Hemi Cooter from there and my motorcycle. My brother helped me drive the Hemi Cooter. And I want to go back there after 30 or 40 years and see El Paso, where things made sense. I'm at the end of my cycle, and it's amazing. I wouldn't have traded that for nothing in the world. What are you gonna say you did to contribute to? I mean, I've been bad all my life, bad and good, but I never went to prison. But I've contributed to society. I contribute even an idea or something to society as a good thing, to help. And what have you did? I don't know. If you think you're just living and you're gonna be dead, that's how you live. It just don't make no sense to just have so much knowledge and die and that be it, or have to go across that scale and they put that feather on there and pull your heart out and you don't even your heart is not even heavy as a feather for all the good deeds you did? None. I would hate to take a chance on that. That's my video.